can be innocent.
Welcome back to another Movie Lingo discussion. I'm Eddie Lingo.
I'm Ron.
I'm Iris.
And I'm Cody.
And this is the full-length Movie Lingo discussion for Batman versus Superman.
Yay!
Full length.
Full length. You're getting it all.
Full 10 inches. Right in your face.
Rah! All right. Yeah. Sorry, microphone.
Oh, all right.
So, is it still recording? Yeah. Okay, we're good. All right. So, let's just skip right into it. Let's start off with the... we already gave our little rating before. Anybody didn't see the previous video?
Check it out.
7 overall Movie Lingo rating. And now we're going to actually go with the spoilers, in-depth discussion. Generally, everybody is satisfied with the movie, some more than others. Now we're going to talk about the movie itself. So let's start with acting. Let's start with Ben Affleck and how everybody felt about him as Batman, and then let's also compare him to Christian Bale. All right, who wants to start that?
I'll go with that.
Already.
Ladies first, you can...
Oh, I was just trying to use my, like, Jedi mind thing to make sure the baby doesn't wake up. All but right. To compare Christian Bale and Ben Affleck...
Jedi can't do that.
I have to say I was actually presently surprised with Ben Affleck because I was a little...
Affleck.
You were pleasantly surprised, right?
Yes, I was. I was pleasantly.
Not presently surprised.
Listen, fuck you. With
that
my
video. Look, I'm just a little bit bi-curious.
And much like the plot of the movie,
you know what? Just
don't throw this in.
Because I like my coffee, so I'm going to say
right,
that.
All right, inside jokes, people. Sorry.
Anyway.
Sorry.
You got to go back and watch the first folks.
They're making fun of my my slight lisp and accents, but it's all right. So basically,
you were surprised.
I was surprised because I don't know. I'm used to like Chasing Amy type Ben Affleck.
Oh yeah.
Not superhero. I'm gonna kick ass.
So Daredevil and Paycheck didn't convince you?
No, not really.
And then The Town didn't show you his badass side. He's been trying to build it up for a while.
I guess. Don't get me wrong. I enjoyed those movies except for Daredevil. I was like, eh.
Oh, that's right. He was in that shit.
He was the Daredevil.
Wait,
are we talking about the same Daredevil?
The only movie that was made.
Yeah, the only movie.
That's right.
With
it
Jennifer
was Ben Affleck.
Yep,
with Jennifer Garner.
Yeah.
He said he was in that.
With his wife.
His wife.
At the time.
Can we just talk about her?
So
wait, are they?
It's a different movie.
They're not together anymore.
They're done.
Is she with someone else?
Where are you at?
Okay, hopefully at some point I'm gonna be able to.
Go ahead, please.
Mention some shit.
Please.
So, anyways, not to repeat what I was trying to say, I was surprised, especially because since they took such a dark way of doing the movie, especially with the Batman character.
Mm-hmm.
I think he did a really good job, and I like the fact that this time around they actually used like a voice covering thing, and he didn't try to do that.
Try to do it himself.
No, stop.
Yeah,
stop.
I like that it was something that modified his voice.
Yeah.
Intentionally, instead of, I mean, something that did it for him instead of
exactly.
Him just trying
and I actually
to have
liked
voice.
How the voice modification sounded. I thought it was good. You know.
It bothered me when I first heard it because I was just like, why does Batman always have to have a voice?
What can't just be a regular
voice? Right. Superman and Clark can't sound exactly the same when they talk.
Yeah,
and that's a worse disguise.
Yeah.
Oh.
But you know, Kimball showed exactly why we need that kind of stuff, because then you'll know who Batman is.
Very true.
Yeah, so. And Clark Kent really isn't a big anybody. You know, he's Bruce Wayne, Mr. Rich Bruce Wayne.
Yeah, he's
Gotham
in the limelight. Everybody sees him, knows him.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So.
I mean, but he could just like use different slang and still talk normal.
Yo, it's the Bat!
Oh my god.
Ripping it up, Gotham style.
And when he said that, I was actually saying, what other slang is he going to use?
You know, he's hi, I'm Bruce Wayne. And we're like, yo, I'm the fucking Bat.
Hey, yo, you bleed?
You will.
We're gonna find out if you bleed. Batman was just super hood.
Oh
I watched it salt as hell.
I actually thought that Ben Affleck was a truer interpretation of Bruce Wayne than Christian Bale was.
So did I.
Because yeah. Christian Bale was too smarmy playboy million. He was Tony Stark essentially.
Okay. Yeah.
He acted more like Tony Stark than he did Bruce Wayne.
I
could see that.
And
they were probably going for that because of the success of Iron Man and Tony Stark.
And Ben Affleck was more brooding and dark.
He was still
hurting. Looked upset that his parents were dead.
He was still dealing with it. A lot of internal demons, you know.
Yeah. So. Yeah, the nightmares and all. So I actually liked,
especially with that crazy bat scene where you see the creature come out and grab him when he's dreaming.
Oh, and the blood's coming from the grave.
And he levitated like Jesus.
Easter egg, man bat.
Oh, true.
That's what that was.
Yes.
I have those comics.
Awesome.
That's true. I liked it in the cartoon.
So the we all agree that Ben Affleck did a great job. You were on board from the beginning, though.
I was on. If you go back,
that's true. He was.
You had to realize his ability to act has come way far than what was the movie with Jennifer Lopez, Gia.
Was it Gia?
I don't know. It's like G-I-G-I, something like that.
It was horrible. Whatever
exactly.
It was.
It's come a long way.
Is it Gia?
No, that was with Angelina Jolie.
Okay, what was the one with?
With Jennifer Lopez. There was one. It wasn't
Jennifer Lopez.
Jersey.
Gigi?
Something like that.
I think it was shit.
Really bad.
It had Al Pacino on the too.
Yeah, it was, I don't know, but it was really bad. He's come a long way.
I gotta look
that
shit up. Okay. I don't want to look it up.
We'll look it up later.
We'll look it up.
It wasn't Gia, though. That was Angelina Jolie. You're right.
Yeah, and what's her name?
He, to me, every scene he was in, he was Batman. Whether in the costume or he was Bruce Wayne, he sold it for me. I thought when the movie would start, I would look at him as, this is Ben.
Yeah.
I had, from the moment he spoke his first word, that's Bruce.
Yeah, I never had any hesitation on it when I thought. I was like, okay, fine.
I did. I was a little
hesitant. A lot of people were extra hesitant, but I didn't have any problem with it at all.
But I think that's what happens when you have someone play a character for so long, and then you bring in someone new. There's always that first slight hesitation.
They didn't really give us time to get over
Christian Bale.
There was another reason why I thought they were fast tracking stuff.
Yeah, like Adam in Star Wars. Yeah. But I was like, what the fuck?
That makes sense.
You didn't do too bad, but Jesus.
No, but I thought he did great. So continue on the acting though, let's talk about Eisenberg.
Oh.
Lex.
Yes.
As Lex. You had an opinion.
Yes, I do. Get me wrong. I think he's a phenomenal actor to me. I think he does a really good job. And I think he did a good job as Lex, but with the type of man that Lex is supposed to be, a very well distinguished, you know, businessman with like a serious attitude with a little bit of crazy under there, I think Jesse took more of a, I'm a bumbling kid with money and I'm got a little bit of Joker personality.
Okay, yeah. I see that, but
I didn't see that at all.
I felt that people can compare him to like almost Jokerish, but for me, I saw the beginning of the since he was young with money, and he kept referencing his father, so it was almost like this new generation. And then we're going to eventually, like he showed at the end, him getting his head shaved. That he will evolve into that Lex that we know, and like this is like this the origin story for everything.
Exactly.
And it's just gonna grow into everything that we wanted to be with the Justice League, with how Lex is, and that's my personal opinion. What do you think?
I could understand that, you know, with him, he's still kind of a kid, so you know he hasn't become that man that he's eventually supposed to become. But I just felt he was just a little bit too bumbling.
But the thing that I took out of it was he's supposed to be full of knowledge. He just loves to like devour knowledge. And you see him with the library. You see him wanting to learn everything on the Kryptonian ship. And in the comic books, again, I look at the comics and the movies and the television as different Earths almost.
They pretty much are.
But they took certain parts from it. And in the beginning when he was introduced, he had hair. He lost hair because of an accident or a situation that he blamed Superman for. Mm-hmm. And even in Smallville, on television show, he was that teenager, different, goofy, you know, hangout guy before.
Yeah, when they were friends.
His animosity towards Superman
turned him into something
so
darker.
I think we get used to the animated series and certain in workings, and we say that's what Lex looks like.
That's the best version, in my opinion.
And what I'm saying is, I'm hoping that they have this set up where we see, much like a certain Star Wars movie, we see that transition.
Yeah.
Because again, that's why I really like the fact that you have some of these main characters who are established actors. And I'm hoping in the next few movies that you're seeing that acting, you're seeing that emotion, because Bruce gave you scenes where you were like pissed at Superman. I'm a Superman fan. And he conveyed that emotion to the audience. Mm-hmm. And I think with Jesse's character, for him to be that guy, like, again, you look at people like Bill Gates, some of the smartest people in the world, they're socially awkward. Something about them is a little off. They read the world different than we do.
Right.
And I think he did a good job of pulling that off.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. You have an opinion on this? So.
What were we talking about? I thought I never looked at it that way.
I'm not the only one that can get deep.
I'm like the, ooh. That's not true.
You know what?
Maybe. I didn't say towards you. I didn't see it the way you did. But now that you mentioned it about like or almost like an origin, I can see that. But it still weirds me out a little bit. I don't know. Don't get me wrong. Like I already said, I like Jesse Eisenberg. I don't think he's a poor actor. I wouldn't say phenomenal. He wouldn't be in my top list of actors. He does a good job for what he does. It felt off to me, but I didn't look at it as an origin story, which makes a little bit more sense, makes me a little bit more open-minded to it. But I did see the Joker in him instead of Lex Luthor. That's totally what I saw.
Yeah, because even in the storyline when, Justice League was starting out, he was already this distinguished man. So that's what I was expecting.
But I just look at, like I said before, that's a different comic, but that's a different.
You gotta consider it as a different universe.
Yeah, that's true.
The cinematic platform they're giving us, that's why they changed the timelines of the death of Superman. They just like meshing everything together to launch this.
Wait. Superman died?
You know what?
Did we not mention that?
Spoiler alert! He doesn't.
For like a day or two.
Not even a day. They're like 6.5 hours.
I mean, oh no,
they took a nap.
Well, however long it takes to build a funeral.
To build, it depends on how much money you got.
Yeah. do a funeral.
Only a day from what I remember.
There was two funerals.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, so they had the one in.
And still, no one put that shit together.
And then I read a story on it. They were trying to say, how did no one put together the Clark and everything? And
Clark disappeared.
Yeah, and he was making not a joke, but he was. When he was directing the movie, he wanted to do the scene without having the extras and everybody knew what was happening. And so what he did was he did two separate funerals. Mm-hmm. And he didn't put a logo on the casket. It was the flag over the casket. He told the actors something world-changing just happened. And I need the emotions if someone died. And it would just and they never gave any clue to it. So when you see the fireman crying, it was these extras who were just going off of, in their head, what could happen to the world that was so great. So they didn't know until the screening, until they actually started watching the movie, they had no idea. So that was something cool to...
Where do you get this? That's just too... What the fuck?
When the movie came out, he actually...
Director?
Director, yeah. Oh, I don't want to butcher his name.
Okay, fine, but...
Asked him stuff.
Okay.
The same thing when I said that extended scene came out. They asked him stuff, and he actually tells you, hey, look, this is how we came up with the scene. This is how we were able to not let anyone know that this part was in the movie. Because, again, the trailer showed majority of what we thought the movie was going to be.
Yeah.
This part was not in there.
I just don't understand how Superman and Clark Kent had funerals at the same time, and no one still was able to put that shit together.
Yeah.
He's Superman, guys. Like... He's wearing glasses.
They even put in the newspaper right there, like Clark Kent missing an action. He will be same missed. Day as.
Yeah, but
for any of you that don't know, Clark Kent is Superman.
Yeah, but
so apparently people can't figure that out.
One thing I like is like how Clark Kent's ceremony was a little bit more.
It was
rural.
Yeah, it was just.
And I mean, the casket was like this wooden box, you know, and
it's a harvest. That's, I'm telling you,
harvest of bodies.
In the interview, he said that's what he called it. He said, we're going to film the harvest scene.
Mm, wow.
And the bagpipes and certain things will play on other movies that he's giving nods to.
All right, so let's get back to the acting, though, before we go deeper into the death of Superman. Wonder Woman. How'd you feel about her?
I liked
her. Did you feel like you were getting a Wonder Woman?
Yeah.
You liked everything about it?
I did.
Yeah, I loved her attitude, and I love how in all the gowns that she wore,
gold.
I think Martha Stewart should have played Wonder Woman.
Martha Stewart, yeah, no.
Yeah, or
And I like
Alexandra Daddario.
And I liked how she bulked up a little bit.
I'm gonna put a picture at the bottom.
He's always mentioning her. She's.
I'm always mentioning someone.
Yeah.
I liked her. What is it Gal Gadot or is it Gal Gadot?
I'm not sure.
I think it's Gadot.
I think
she could be Galingo.
Whatever you want to be.
Yeah. Gal Galingo.
Yeah.
Gal Gadot.
And her compared to the Fast and Furious movie, she was a lot thinner. So I like that she put a little bit of more meat on her body.
Mm-hmm.
Even though in most movies or cartoons or comic books, she's more of an Amazonian, really big, butched type woman.
Mm-hmm.
But I like that they feminized her, you know, a little bit with the body, but she still wasn't as scrawny.
I would have had a lifelong erection if they would have gotten Gina Carano to play her and just slimmed it down a little bit. That would have been perfect for me. I'm sorry.
You lost it. Right there. And there's his load gone.
Okay, anyway, moving on.
Didn't moving last on. Very long, jeez.
Ah, sorry about that.
It's like I said in the other one, you're invited. It doesn't matter.
That's it.
Doesn't matter what time you got to the party, as long as you were invited.
Yeah, so, okay, so now...
didn't even get to enjoy the party.
It's no, some of us did. Yeah. Some of us did.
You missed the bus.
What is it that Bernie Mac used to say? 2 minutes. You got 2 minutes.
What does the next topic that you wanted to bring up, sir?
The story.
Oh, wow. Okay, so you want to get down into the depressing parts already?
That's the
because that story had so much wrong and so many holes. Go ahead.
Yeah.
Lead your charge on your first point with the story.
More holes than a strip club.
Yeah, it did. And and that was the cause and effect of making it a PG-13 movie. Uh-huh. And it's tough to remember that with everything, it was a PG-13 movie, even though it was darker.
Mm-hmm.
You had an origin story, multiple, I feel, origin stories or teasing that was in there. I felt half-assed the Justice League coming out. You had some time to come up, create a way to introduce these characters, which we knew were going to happen to come out, but the best you had was clicking on a link.
Yeah.
You had the dream sequences that I get, again, it was, the biggest flaw of this movie, in my opinion, was too many storylines. And as soon as you got on a tempo of a storyline, they gave you
another one.
Granny's peach tea, and the movie became something completely different. Again, remember, the movie starts off political.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it really hits some lines that when you leave the theater, you're talking about gun control and a bunch of other stuff.
Okay.
Then after that, it becomes something completely different to the point that Batman is hiding behind something and kind of walking around saying, oh, what do you want me to do? You want me to stand here?
So to me, I really have nothing to contribute to this fight.
The redemption of what the director was trying to do.
I got one of these left.
I only have one. Yeah, I'm just saving it. I'm just waiting for when he does the uncut version or that rated R version. I'm hoping with that extra time as a fan that you're able to go back and see what storyline he was really telling. But to me, the biggest flaw was just too much going on.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
There's one scene that really bugged me, story-wise. When they blow up the guy in the wheelchair.
Yes.
And everything around him blows up.
Right.
And Superman, he's just in the fire and you see his face.
Yeah.
His face did not look sad.
He did kind of look like he was
He looked like.
What emotion do you think he should have had? That's the emotion he should have had. He looked.
But that's what he looked. Oh, fuck, right?
Yeah.
Yes, but that's what I would have had. Like remember when they said, got me.
He said, hey, look, I wasn't even looking. He's like, he let his guard down.
Right, because he could have seen
humanity.
It.
He just sitting there. Hey, he could have.
You want it sad? I thought that was a perfect.
I thought it was perfect. Like, oh,
like
look
these motherfuckers. Yeah.
Because exactly.
I'd have to agree. Like, fuck, I just fucked up.
They're going
to
blame this shit.
They're going to blame this shit on me.
Fuck, man.
You didn't feel it?
They're already.
I mean, I felt that, but I felt maybe some tears.
You wanted more tears.
Or maybe you know what? Maybe he's thinking in his head, the storyline's gonna.
This is what we're doing with this.
In the comic books, the Asian chick who's Lex's bodyguard,
yeah.
Mercy,
she just died. Mercy?
Yeah,
yeah, she just died.
But later on, he rebuilds her, so she'll be back.
Yeah,
yeah, she's like his bodyguard.
He's just thinking about where are we gonna go with this storyline. That's what he was thinking. So when you go back and you watch that scene, that's what he's thinking.
And I kind of liked the Granny Peach Tea thing. I thought it was funny.
It was funny,
I thought it was
actually.
Dark funny. Like, she couldn't even finish her thing. She's like,
but I, you know what I thought was going to happen?
And it says Granny's Peach Tea.
Because she said you're not going to, you know, yeah.
Did anybody see that coming, though?
No, I thought she was going to, I thought he poisoned her. I thought she was going to die. I thought that's why she couldn't speak. I didn't know she was getting that shaken up about it. And then all of a sudden,
to watch a full theater, and again, I saw Avengers, had no problem with the movie, enjoyed the movie, but how many superhero movies do you watch that gives you more than those cheering moments, those bright, happy, comedic moments?
Mm-hmm.
This, with the Man-Bat coming out in that dream sequence, him coming through that wall when he was going Arkham Knight style,
mm-hmm.
that stuff caught the audience off guard, and you watched them jump in their seat, you watched them sit back when that thing exploded, like, what the fuck now?
Yeah.
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 That shit was nice. I'm gonna watch it again.
Killed a whole bunch of people.
Yeah. I'm gonna watch it again today.
The only thing that bothered me, just to go back to the peach, the grandma's granny's peach tea thing.
You didn't give the recipe.
Not smart ass. That I feel like her expression of it was just a little bit too scared. If I would have saw that, I would have been like, this fucking smart ass.
Yeah, I put you on that one. Like, you see it, and then you're like, oh, you know, like, what? You done
how
it
was
now.
That, boom. How was that smart ass cup of piss?
Oh, boom.
You know what? But what if
you know,
what really if shaken up.
It yeah, really like, did look like a glass of piss, by the way. It looked was. Like any peach tea.
But yeah. What I'm saying is,
it really did. But I'm like, I would be more pissed like this fucking but smart ass.
But I think that's how it started. When she first looks at it, she's almost like, But she tries to get back to it. Then she starts connecting the dots, looking at the chair.
But the way she got distracted, she was generally fearful, which she should have been more angry, like, the nerve of this guy.
Yeah, like,
you know? But she was actually scared. Like, she knew what was coming.
Do you think there was some part of her that knew what was about to come?
Yeah, I was like, and how does a cup of piss, you know, signal to a bomb?
You think that she knew?
Because the director kept giving you the chair, even to the point where the assistant was sitting there looking at the chair like, why isn't he
blowing up
yet? And before you can figure anything... I don't know about all. I don't even think she knew.
I know, but isn't there a shot where they show the Asian chick's face where she's like,
fuck. Was she realizing that some shit's about to go down?
She's like, yo, what the?
Yeah.
Oh, this. Yeah. Oh.
And that's pretty much all the time she had to react.
All right, I'm just gonna hold my breath.
Okay.
But I love Superman's face. He just closes his eyes and he's like, fuck.
Getting back to the point about the different things that they kept throwing at you. From what I heard rumor-wise, I haven't read anything. I haven't done my
research
like I was supposed to. Sorry. But from word of mouth and other conversations, almost everything, like that moment where Bruce Wayne is downloading the hacked files and he
encrypted,
and when he wakes up, that guy in the portal is yelling.
Flash.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, and then also then the dream sequence he had with those flying beings came, is all leading to Darkseid coming.
Uh-huh.
So I feel like they, even though they kept throwing stuff in there that kind of threw you off, and then they had, you know, it was still kind of still keeping it in the bigger picture that we just don't see yet.
Exactly. And that's
maybe, yeah, I can see that. They threw it at you, but they didn't throw it right in your face.
So for people who aren't knowledgeable of where this could possibly, it just seems like a whole bunch of random bullshit.
Yep,
like,
that's me.
What the fuck was that? And then what is this?
If you don't have previous knowledge of what's going on,
right, which is,
you know, of like, oh my god, that's from,
for a movie to be that long and you want to make it clear for people who don't
know,
they missed the mark on that one.
And that's what was so glaring, like, it was a slow pace at that.
Yeah,
and it was like a slow pace. I didn't want a bunch of action scenes. Don't get me wrong. I didn't want like Batman and Superman fighting for 55 minutes.
I did want it at least 15, not 10.
A little bit longer. You just wanted to see Batman go Arkham Knight harder on Superman.
Oh man, we're gonna talk about that next.
But he blew his load. Like, remember the first step? Like, okay, this track didn't work. This trick didn't work. The guns didn't work. Let's go to the Kryptonite. Like, he had, before you knew it, he already had got to the end.
He's bolder than me. I would have had the Kryptonite from jump.
Yeah.
But then your fight scene would have been 5 minutes.
I mean, yeah. I mean, well, at least I like the idea of it wearing off the little gas thing. I like how the fight can go back and forth with that because it was wearing off. But anyway, we're getting off track. We're still talking about the holes in the story and the execution. Cody, did you have any problems with?
I mean, I don't think I can. I really can't contribute that much to this.
The DC universe is not.
I'm not anywhere familiar with the DC universe.
Gotcha.
So I mean. Like you said, those scenes where Darkseid and Flash came in, I was like, hey, that's Flash. Like, I know Flash. What the fuck does it mean? Why is he here? What's he doing?
I have to agree with that scene being a little off.
Yeah.
Because my mother went to go see the movie with me, and when she saw the dream scene, she's like, who the hell is that supposed to be? I was like, Mom, it's the Flash. And she's like, but what does that have to do with what's going on right now? And I'm like, they're just giving you a foreshadowing.
But they're taking it. They're taking it
back in business, baby.
But they're taking it out of the comic book because I believe there's something in Infinite Crisis where before he dies, he runs around and he starts to tell them what's happening. So to Batman, we don't know if that's a dream sequence or an actual manifesto of something happened. But what we believe is Batman takes it the wrong way, as you're right about him, and it could be something else. Like, again,
it was a warning about something bigger, but he took it as.
Gotta kill Superman.
Yeah. And that's why, again, at the end, you have Lex saying, they're coming already. The bell's been
wrong.
Does that mean because you activated the ship? that they know you're here. Again, when you look at the cameos, like when you look at Cyborg, when that, and it was a great actor to play his dad. So that that movie's promising already on that level. But that black box that they use, that's from his world. And so to have that involved.
Oh, like yeah, that's before, the AllSpark cube, right? From
From Transformers.
Oh, God. And he got me to go, I was like,
yeah.
Oh, that's what that shit looked like,
You know, and then you made that face that Superman made in the courtroom.
I did. There you go. There you go. Fuck that face. So now we've just summed that up. That's that face. You mother Cody.
That's the first thing I thought when I saw that. I was oh, so this is Cyborg, and he also is he's a Transformer.
Damn.
Cyborg's here. Hey, guys.
they could have cleaned up the storyline. Like, after you've seen it and you kind of get the sequences and what they're there for with purpose, you can understand. But again, there's little small, like, Aquaman looked like he couldn't breathe. Like, he looked like he was holding his breath.
No, it... Okay. I need to know. Why?
Like, we couldn't figure that out better?
Why was he... Yeah. Why did he stare at that thing for so long?
Yes. You want to see me? You paid the admission. I've got to do this. I have to. And then I kind of get like,
that was
maybe,
such a long scene for
maybe
that.
Maybe they were saying, like, hey, listen, you're in the water. You're part of nature. We need your hair to do some squid octopus thing. Okay?
Yeah, then you need, take off. It was in the contrary. I have to be beautiful for at least 30 seconds.
I know. And then damn eyebrows.
How much money
do
you think
he
got paid
eyebrows.
Just for that 40-second scene?
I would agree.
Well, they start shooting, what, on the 11th of April?
Even though...
No, I'm saying for that 40-second scene, Jason Momoa probably got more money than I'll ever see in my life.
Probably so.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Like, combined of everything. Nah. But that scene bugged me because he's like, yeah.
How did you
hey,
find
guys,
me?
I'm yeah. Aquaman. What's up, guys? Yeah? What's you ready up? For the next movie? Hey.
I am.
Oh, shit, I gotta go? All right. Bah! That was it.
Yeah.
Cyborg scene? Pretty cool.
That was cool.
That made sense. Star Labs, and the Flash.
You can see at the bottom of the screen. And
I didn't care for the Flash sequence.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, I thought it was very simple, you know, like, just to show that his power
was. Oh, in the gas station?
Yeah.
It was...
I mean, what were they supposed to do?
That's basically what it was.
I don't know. I just wish they could have come up with something else for him to have to deal with.
All of them. But to me, like you said before... There's a storyline in which I don't think the editing was done properly to give you that story. And I felt like Superman had to die because if you're setting up the Justice League...
So wait, I have a question then.
Go for it.
Are they not planning on incorporating Green Lantern into the Justice League?
Well, the rumor is they're going to give him pick three Lanterns to carry and do their own movie. Whether or not they tie in the Justice League, the first part.
Gotcha.
That's a question.
Because there was no folder for him.
Nope.
Yeah. And I got a little confused because when I saw the circle, like, they had on the file for Cyborg.
Oh, okay. Because when I saw the Aquaman, I thought it was the Arrow.
And the thing is, they clicked it so fast that I was like, wait a minute. Was that Cyborg or was that for Green Lantern?
Yeah,
because
it was Cyborg, Aquaman.
And Flash.
And Flash.
And Flash.
And Wonder Woman.
And then Wonder Woman.
Oh, Wonder Woman had her own.
Yeah, she had her own file. Folder. That's where they found the picture.
Mm-hmm.
Which was a cool picture, I'm not going to lie.
Teaser for the movie.
I dig that picture.
Yeah.
Them all badass, dressed up, looking ready to kick some shit.
Mm-hmm. And I wonder if... And if you look in that picture,
wonder?
I don't know if I'm right or not, but it looked like... What?
She said, I wonder.
And you were talking about Wonder Woman.
Shut up.
But
God, why are you so aggressive?
Breast milk.
Yep. You push a baby out, and all of a sudden your heart is shit.
The hormones
just rushing through her body.
But
no, I think she's Hispanic.
I think they're gonna
That's a big part of it.
They're gonna do
Russian. No, she's Hispanic.
Like Russian. In the picture that they see Wonder Woman, right next to her is Chris. Looks like Chris Pine.
It looked like Chris Pine.
Right,
so
it
that's
it is, isn't it?
Yes. It is.
So also, I'm you're being serious.
I was in the movie. I was like, that's Chris Pine.
Yes.
And everyone was like, oh, you're so stupid.
No, I've seen it. Yeah.
So
Pine.
That's why I was
it's
like.
100% Chris. And so he's got that smirk on his face. Like, yeah, motherfucker, I made it.
It's
you guys
me.
Didn't think I was going to be in it.
Chris Wait, who does
okay.
Is he
I thought so because
like
I was like, that's.
Character,
I think
or?
He's her love interest back
oh, okay,
in the past.
Gotcha.
And remember, she says 100 years ago. She goes, well, 100 years, I had to get away from mankind. That's about the same date as the picture.
Mm.
So I'm guessing in the origin story, they're going to show you why, for whatever reason,
she had to, step
she had
away.
To separate.
Heartbreak.
Yeah.
Fucks us all up.
But think, like, when Superman died, the way, like I said before, the way I look at how they were setting this up again, almost 10-plus movies, wouldn't it kill the value of the storyline or something for you more believable if Superman recruits the Justice League? Because you're Superman. Why wouldn't you want to work with Superman?
Yeah.
Versus Batman, who's trying to get these people who are almost godlike for his purpose.
I, well, obviously from the right before credits with the dirt rising up, Superman will be there for the recruiting process. He better be. I'm going to be pissed. If the dirt's still rising when they start the next movie, and Batman's done like 2 years of recruiting, I'm not watching the rest of it. I'm going to get up and walk out.
I would be. I think that'd be badass. Like,
I have checked out officially DC.
2 years of dirt rising. Like, no, but you, what the fuck is that?
it's like 8 miles into the atmosphere.
Home Depot commercial. It pops up. It's like, oh, it's that time. Springtime. Let's do more. Whatever.
What were you going to say about that?
But I just look at it as, again, you maybe they're setting you up for something. When they tease you with that almost bizarro look or that zombified look in space to watch him regenerate.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, from the sun. That was awesome. I can look that.
You need a bigger adversary, whether Brainiac or who. Maybe you need a bigger adversary.
I don't want to see Brainiac.
To have him come back.
So you want him to basically pull a Goku.
Basically.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
you want him to still be dead or trying to get back while everybody's fighting this enemy that they can't handle.
Exactly.
And then, and then he flies in
on the Nimbus with Sensu beans.
And saves the day.
He's like, all right, Justice League, I got this.
I was like, fly the Nimbus.
Listen, could you imagine how amazing that would be?
Do you think Superman can channel his eye beams through his hands?
Listen, apparently right now he can lift dirt.
He's actually an earthbender.
I would not be cool with that.
They did a little mix of Avatar in there too.
Yeah, I would not be cool with that at all. Let's, you know what, we keep going back to this, so let's go ahead and address the death of Superman. Cody, how did you feel about that being incorporated in this movie?
There was,
because there's a lot of mixed opinions.
There was no part of me at any point in time in that movie when after he fights Doomsday where I even legitimately thought that Superman was permanently dead. There's no, it loses its power because you know he's not dead. So the scene is just like, oh, Superman's dead.
He just needs some sunlight.
Yeah, like he just,
and they close it off.
He just needs to take a nap. There was no part of me that was like, when he died, I was like, okay.
Right.
When Han Solo died,
you knew he was
that
dead.
That shit wrecked me. I was like,
what?
Oh, fuck.
You and me both. I was in the theater like, oh god.
So when Superman died, I was just like, all right, so what? Is he gonna come back at the end, or we're just gonna see him in the next movie?
Yeah, right. But is that because you don't follow the comic book on that half? Versus,
does he ever die?
He did multiple times.
But he comes back.
Yeah.
Yes.
There you go.
That's I'm with him on that one. I wasn't affected by that at all because I knew that even if he didn't come back at the end of this, he's going to be back. So it didn't have any effect on me. So
that's
all
the
emotion they put into it.
One of the things that
draw.
Bugs me in like the comic book world, you have those characters like Superman is one of them, Wolverine is one of them. When they, you don't feel anything when they die because you know they're coming back.
You just don't know exactly when.
Okay, but that's what I'm saying. That's from you guys, because I give you an example. I'm sitting there with my wife, Elizabeth. Hi, how you doing?
Good job.
You did that like she wasn't your wife. Like you were actually trying to hit her up and get her number. Like, hey, how you doing, baby?
Good job.
But we're sitting there and she's next to me and we left the theater and she's like, I couldn't believe he died. I'm like, what are you? I was like, oh. Because she doesn't follow comic books. She doesn't do the movies.
I guess.
So she completely thought he was going to come. It was like, oh, he's out there in space. He's going to come back fine. He comes back. Then when he actually died and you're watching the funeral, she's like, is he going to come back? I'm like, and I didn't spoil it for him. Like,
right, of course.
He doesn't come back. And at the end, when the dirt lifted, she was like, okay, so what's going to happen next? I'm like, you got to find out. So again, that goes into the rating of that PG-13. That you're trying to get a general audience to reboot a whole cinematic universe.
Yeah.
And so that wasn't for us.
That was not for us.
You're right.
Han Solo hurt.
There's a lot of moments that weren't for us.
Yeah, the Han Solo, I felt that. Like
you
said.
I wasn't sad at all when Superman died at all. But even, okay, when it comes to me, I don't really follow DC like that. I'm more of a Marvel. But I do love Superman.
Mm-hmm.
So like,
Superman.
Yeah, Superman. Mm. I love me some Superman. Mm. So,
give it to her. She wouldn't even know what happened. Like, oh, I'm sleeping.
He would kill you.
You don't know that.
All right.
Superwoman over here.
Superwoman.
Why you gotta take shit to the next level?
Do you? It's like you haven't known me for a year.
I didn't. I pregnancy brain, and then like I gave birth, and like it's all rebooted.
Oh, we're starting over.
Yeah.
Okay. I was not paying attention when she said pregnancy brain. I'm like, that's something new.
This just in: Iris is pregnant again.
Yeah. Hell no. Mm-mm. The thing is, even like if you're a type of person that just knows just like basic things about Superman, such as myself, I already assumed that he would come back. Mm-hmm. You know, like even not knowing, like, oh my god, there's comic books where Superman dies. I didn't know that. I would still assume, first of all, it's the first fucking movie.
Right.
And people would be pissed.
Dawn of Justice.
Yeah, it's like, we're just starting the Justice League. The nigga has to come back.
Pretty much.
Because if he doesn't, it's like, fuck the rest of the movie.
What are we doing?
Like, you signed, like, no, he's got to come back. He signed for 3 more movies.
Yeah, like, it's in the contract.
That guy in the theater shouting that out.
Yeah, yeah.
There was these kids in the theater as they were leaving the movie talking about, like, I guess they weren't really super familiar with Superman.
Super familiar?
Yeah. So they were...
We're just playing on words. We need to do a chime every time someone does
that. Super wonder.
And they were, and one of the kids was like, is kryptonite, like, the only way that they can kill Superman? Like, what if they just, like, put him underwater for, like, a really long time? Or they just put it, like, what if they... One of the kids said, quote, what if they threw him in a volcano and sealed the volcano with kryptonite?
Okay,
well,
see...
Well, damn.
Okay, wait, hold on. First of all, they want him dead forever.
Yeah. But that was back, such overkill.
Wait, that goes back to what Eddie was saying, is why they keep coming up with these movies with origins for people like that.
Yeah, for people
so
like
people
that.
Who should already know how Batman started... You've got to do an origin for that person.
True.
Yeah.
That is true.
I got to change it up, especially for the little children.
So everybody, I mean, a lot of people seem to really focus on that when they come out of the theater. Like, that was the biggest part of the movie.
No.
That wasn't the biggest part for me, though.
Maybe, but maybe it's like he said.
When he has the spear, and he's going towards Doomsday with the spear, if you take your television, okay? And you turn it up where he's flying upward, it's basically the same ending in a way as Superman Returns. It's a piece of kryptonite, it's weakening him, and as he's gotta get it up there.
That's actually what they did, Ron. Okay, they just took the old footage and they just turned it
sideways. Can we talk about that? I was
and
really bothered.
Turn the TV sideways like he fucking did it. Okay.
I was really bothered that he chose to go down after. I was falling out in my seat. When he was like, I don't get it, he went to go save her.
Uh-huh.
And then he was like, okay, now I gotta go get this. I'm like, no, Batman has been missing in action for 15 minutes.
Perfect time for
him. Go get Batman him and tell him to get it, you know? Yeah. And no, he goes down and gets it, and he's unsuccessful. He's just floating.
Yeah, and he had already took off his electronic armor.
Okay, but that's a head nod to the previous Superman movies where he had to do that one time.
Okay.
And some of these are nods.
It's like homage.
Yeah. Okay.
Let's talk about the biggest cock tease ever, which is when Lois Lane tries to get the spear and she's drowning and they have no and you're
Aquaman.
Like
waiting
okay,
for
we've
him
seen
here?
Aquaman. We've seen Aquaman. We know he's a part of this. And they're showing showing water for like 15 minutes. She's
they
dying.
Did on
she's
purpose.
Drowning for
he knew
so
what he was
long.
Doing.
They're drowning for so long. You're just like, oh my god, she's drowning in the water. Aquaman's gonna do it. No, fuck it. You guys can still wait. I wanted to see more Aquaman
you said
than I did of Superman.
I thought you were talking about when Wonder Woman gets hit by Doomsday.
Oh, and
she kind of opens her legs a little bit, and she kind of like
she's like ooh.
Curls her lips and then takes off right back at him. Like, what move? How did they get this PG-13? There should be a death toll at the bottom.
No. Well, remember, just because they imply innuendo in the movie doesn't change the rating. As long as it's not directly in your face, like, oh, yes, come fuck me.
And the editing with a lot of the people that got killed didn't actually show them die. As soon as the gunshot, they switch, you know.
Implied, the rating, you know, can be PG-13.
Can stay PG-13. We just saw the building explode from the outside.
Oh, my God. That would be so fucking awesome.
She would have just been like,
so, Doomsday.
Doomsday, my pussy.
Doomsday
and who I am.
Does not follow the comic book again. It's a different realm.
Right.
Yeah.
Has nothing to do with Zod, nothing to do with Lex's blood. That's Superboy, if you want to count anything like that. But.
I didn't like Doomsday.
But I
didn't I'm going to go ahead and say it.
I didn't like how they lied and said that's not his final form. Basically, it was.
This movie, he's just Dragon Ball Z. He was just going Super Saiyan, evolving. Just like next level.
The character does, but. The end result where you had the bony, like when he dies, that you do have the shards of bone and he does have that resemblance of it. This more, unless I think, again, it was a story, like Eddie was saying, there's a story that's being told, and because it wasn't edited properly, we don't see it until after we realize it. So for him to get these bony, for him to get this arm chopped off and that growth was what allowed that end climax for Superman. Because you watch him impaled, and he literally aggressively like pulls himself closer so he can get deeper inside.
Right. How about that?
I was gonna say that's what she said.
Oh, yeah. Welcome back, Iris. So, so we don't need to spend much time on the Doomsday thing. I mean, but this did play out exactly like we said it would, pretty much, because the trailer pretty much gave us the whole movie. I mean, there was a little bit more to it, more setup.
I like that Robin suit we saw.
with the Joker writing on it and the staff that he's holding.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, we saw that through the trailer.
The Riddler that was on the backside. You had the Joker card tapped to his gun, taped to his gun on the dream sequence.
Right.
Oh, there's a Riddler? Oh, the question mark?
The question mark.
That's right. True.
So, we know from it was leaked online, those photos, that Batman's going to be in the Suicide Squad.
Oh, really?
That Batman is going to be
the world of
you didn't see that? Oh, okay, yeah.
Yeah, no, he was.
Yeah, I saw it.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
All right. World, I was like, wait. Because
I think that's Will Smith.
The photos that I got weren't online. It was from somebody that was on set. So I was like, wait, did I just ruin something? But it was online, right?
I saw it online.
Okay, all right.
So
okay.
If anything, you can put the picture at the bottom.
I wanted to make sure that it. I thought it went out.
Where did you see this, though?
They were filming in Toronto, and Batman was on top of the Joker's car in the streets and was doing something. They were driving and filming.
Yeah,
so when they were filming, I there was somebody I knew that just happened to have some stills, and they provided it for me. Okay, and I was keeping it to myself, wasn't gonna say anything, and then I saw it online. And I was like, yay, I can tell people I know now. So great. So, but Batman is gonna be moving in on. Suicide Squad.
Okay.
But I also heard rumored that so is Lex. You think they're gonna break him out?
I hope not.
I hope if they do, again, you're seeing that character
develop
that you want.
Yeah. If they do that, I'd be okay with it.
The prison's definitely going to harden him.
He has, that's what I'm looking at.
Not in a good way.
What'd you say?
I said, I can't wait to see the Suicide Squad.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, that's going to be good.
I'm actually super excited about that.
Yeah.
I said super.
Super excited. Super.
Oh, Ryan, you had another point that you wanted to bring up?
I'll watch it probably again today. I just really enjoy the Easter eggs. Like I was telling Cody earlier,
that's me.
The opening scene where you're getting that Martha death retell story. A lot of that comes page by page out of the comic book, from the breaking of the pearl to the Excalibur was a nod at the running time of the movie is the same as what that movie was when it came out. There's a I think a Star Wars trailer or a poster that's blurred out of the back. The poster you see from Zorro was a nod at the first American hero that started comic books for the most part. So there was a lot of little nuggets throughout the whole movie. So when I go back and watch it, I'm literally just looking at stuff in the background.
Awesome.
That's what gets me to watch it multiple times. All
right, because I'm going to get into the final debate, even though it's probably going to be not much of a debate. But before I get into that, I want to make sure.
I feel like I know what you're going to ask.
Well, you know what you're going to. You know what I'm going to ask. I'm going to ask two questions. But you sure you don't have any other points before we get into this final?
It's tough because I'm pretty sure you're going to pull something out. I'm like,
okay.
So just do it.
All right. So who won the fight?
Batman.
Yeah. Are you not going to give me the? Here we go.
I'm going to go with Batman.
Well,
and the reason why I go with Batman is again you're taking realms out of the comic book. Could Superman have gotten rid of him at the front where you see that kind of smack that shows that power?
Yeah.
Or the part where, and I like how they were telling where in the comic books, Kryptonite doesn't weaken him immediately. It's something that the dosage manifests in him. And when you, the thing I like about Superman or even Doomsday or Incredible Hulk from Marvel is when you hit them with the strength of, let's say, 7, the next time you hit them, it has to be greater than because their body's going to adapt.
Adjust, yeah.
And that's why you see that scene where Batman's punching him. You're seeing Superman take the hit, the blood, and then all of a sudden you see Superman's head not move as much to not move at all. So now it's damaging his, so you see that but once the playing field was even with Kryptonite, he had the kill shot. If Lois doesn't show up and stop it, much like the
you
comic
think he,
book,
you guys think he would have done it? 100%?
Yeah.
In the comic if he would, book,
yeah.
In if the Lois comic Lane book, the only thing like, that
wait,
stops him,
you guys have the same mom name.
Yeah, I honestly believe that he was like
he was gonna
getting
do it.
Even more angry, like fuck you said my mom's name for?
And just multiple stabs. But
it's like, what do you know about that?
Did you fuck my mom?
In the comic book, it's funny because he stopped because of a heart attack. And through the battle and the damage, that's because it's all
Batman
left.
Batman stops
see.
For a heart attack?
He starts for because what happens is once he gets punched enough in his chest, the armor moves so that he can see through the lead. And he sees that Bruce is having a heart attack. Again, this is an older Bruce.
Right.
He's starting to have a heart attack and he says, hey, you need to stop doing it. You're going to have a heart attack. And I don't remember word for word. I mean, maybe you can put it at the bottom. But in the animated series, it actually shows he says one of the most epic lines is something along the lines of, remember this moment that me, a regular mortal, a regular man, could end you that's going to end you. And then he dies. And I won't spoil it. Yes, I will. He fakes his death in the comic book. But The only difference
was instead of him having didn't actually die?
To my Batman.
Wow, Batman. What a surprise. Yeah. A common character didn't die.
DC does it again.
DC does it again.
I wasn't surprised because it takes little pieces of...
It's funny because I expected you guys to, being Superman fans, to just not admit at all.
Well, what did I tell you this movie was going to do? If you're a Superman fan, it was going to make you respect Batman and what he was coming from and vice versa. I walked in, Superman fan, and I completely respect what Batman was doing. And then the moral issues of the storyline, again, you fail to realize at the beginning of the movie, Superman killed the guy for a woman. There's no fucks given.
Yeah.
He killed someone.
It's different for me.
And then when you look at Batman, Batman killed a bunch of people. Some people feel some type of way about that.
Yeah, and I think feel some type of way?
Exactly. And because you couldn't get that full moral out of the storyline, you missed that. And that's the questions you have. But I would say...
It didn't bother me at all.
Yeah. It didn't really bother me.
So, yeah, because I know that there are different...
I like the Batman with the gun.
They're different... Different Batmans out there throughout the legacy of Batman,
and there's gonna be a brand new one.
And there's some darker ones. And yeah, he held some guns. Yeah, he turned some guns at people. And you know, I wanna go ahead and say that Batman in that warehouse was like living the video game. Best night of my life. Okay. I'm telling you, he did
best fight of my life.
Everything that you love in the video game, from jumping through the floor, throwing the devices to disable the guns, and he's grappling people and clotheslining and grappling the objects at people, and then he's coming through the walls, and then he's hanging people upside down. Everything that you love about the video game,
that warehouse was pretty sick.
They gave us that, and I just.
Okay, then what about that scene where you had the rookie cop and the vet cop, which also comes from the comic books, and you have him hiding
up top,
barely in the camera view, and as your eyes are trying to focus,
adjust
like
to see him.
And then you watch how smoothly he just takes off and leaps.
Yeah, and all you see is the end of the cave going.
Yeah.
That was awesome. I like that. That was nice.
That was effective, nice. Batman. That was awesome.
I think that definitely did a lot for me. They really, there were a lot of moments that were like paying homage to either comics or video games, and then mixing up a lot of things. And so the aggressiveness of this Batman was more towards the latest video games for me, and it didn't bother me at all. So I don't care who's upset about him actually killing people. And I've actually, one of my biggest problems with Superman, the reason I've refused to be a Superman fan, is because he won't kill anybody.
Except
from
for Zod.
But my knowledge is only from Justice League television series, Ultimate Justice League and the regular Justice League. So,
well, I think those ones were just specifically made for kids.
They are, but I thought that was just the one thing that never changed, no matter what realm or what universe Superman's running, that he just won't kill anybody. So when he did that for a woman, I was like, oh yeah, because even if that was one of my things, like, I won't kill anybody. What'd you do to my woman? Okay. Well, I won't kill anybody after this. You know?
Restart.
Zero days without killing.
No death. There's a sign behind you. There's no death. It's Tuesday. Oh, start again.
Yeah, there you go. There you go.
That's funny.
Awesome. So.
I honestly think that Batman kind of won in that. He did. What the fuck? Who's gonna pick Superman? Like, he literally beat shit out of him. I mean, it was cool how he was like, okay, I got used to how you're fighting me, and yeah, I'm harder than, okay, but like, I don't know. It just, the hits that Batman was landing were just, they were crunching. They hurt.
Okay, I'm glad you guys agree. Because, I mean, I've been arguing with people for days, and the Superman fans were, they don't want to give him the credit because they know that in those first couple of moments, when he was trying to talk him out of the fight, Superman could have just ripped him in half.
Yeah.
Because there was no kryptonite right there in that moment being used. It was the guns, and it was the first trap.
Yeah.
And Superman could have easily just, all right, this is over. So they didn't want to give Batman the credit. But technically, because Superman chose to engage him still.
It's his fault.
Not only that, but you see that him being naive, I think this Superman doesn't fully know what he's capable of.
Right.
He still thinks he's the greatest thing since sliced bread. So when he catches and it works perfectly for Batman's use, when he catches the arrow, Batman doesn't want you to get hit by the arrow. It was never the plan.
No, it was never the plan.
So when it pops, it's like, what the fuck is this? He used his brain, not a special ability, not a meta.
That's why I say Batman's like the Martha Stewart of the Justice League. Oh, yeah? He gets very creative.
Oh, wow. That's how you do it.
Martha Stewart. MacGyver would have been more
bad. Hey, how about that? The MacGyver of the Justice League or the MacGruber?
MacGyver Stewart.
I have MacGruber something the other day at work. We ran out of envelopes for the coins.
Everybody died?
No.
That's normally how it is.
You know what? So it wasn't a MacGruber moment.
He stops and has a regular conversation.
I died of laughter when Eddie showed me these two post-it notes he made into an envelope.
He stapled the post-its around to hold the coins and the deposit.
I don't say MacGyver because of the fact that he's not grabbing objects from his surroundings and trying to create something.
Okay.
This is technology he already has.
That he can afford.
Exactly.
That's flown in.
Uh-huh, basically.
So he didn't grab an object like a plutonium rock and melt that down and turn that into other objects to use.
Yeah, but look what he had to use. He had to use computer.
He had to use high-tech stuff to do it. That he had access to, MacGyver will take something of
now,
nothing
and make
Martha
it. Stewart,
I get what you're saying.
When I say Martha Stewart, I'm just saying the idea is like, okay, I have this rock. I can break it down. I can make bombs with it.
I can make a pound cake.
I don't think I've ever watched Martha Stewart break something down like that. I've got three rocks.
Ooh, I can
make a
quilt with kryptonite.
Oh my God,
wrap you in a nice warm little kryptonite snuggie.
You know what? Now it makes
kryptonite
sense
gift
with the
basket.
Martha Stewart thing because there was so many references
to Martha Stewart.
No, I'm trying to make it as close reference as I can. Wizard of Oz, where he says, "Where does Clark go? Does he click his heels and go Kansas for the Smallville jokes?"
Mm-hmm.
Or when he says, "At the bottom of the ocean was Emerald City."
Yes.
There we go.
So little small references in the movie. Again, after you see it like two or three times, you stop watching the storyline. You ignore it.
Yeah.
You make your own.
Make your own. That's what most of the people that watch these movies, make their own. And you hear them walking out. I'm like, what are you going with this? Like, where are you getting that shit?
Okay, but okay, what?
We're making our own based on.
How do you guys feel about the ratings though? Because I feel like I watch Avengers 2 Reloaded. I mean, Age of Ultron, where it was the same storyline.
Be quick about it. It's fun about the.
I felt like they were just harsh for no reason.
Two theories on that. One, I feel like everybody's strictly judging on the plot holes and the misleading points and the way the story was. As a writer, the movie is trash, okay? But I didn't watch it as a writer.
Mm-hmm.
That's not what I wanted from this. I wanted a solid platform for more. I wanted the origin for more, so I let the writing go. Like the stupid story with the bullets that went nowhere. That Lois Lane.
I completely forget it happened.
Yeah, and they set.
Oh, yeah.
And they
I actually
Superman
forgot
up,
about that.
Right, and they set Superman up for what? I mean, they had a good setup already with the explosion and the thing. They didn't even need that bullet story.
They didn't need that whole segment.
You know, they didn't need it. He was going to come out there and save her regardless.
Jimmy Olsen dying at the beginning of the movie?
Right. What
was that for?
And he was going to come out there and save her regardless of whether those bullets were there or not. It was just stupid. Like, there's a bunch of stuff as a writer. This movie's horrible.
Yeah.
But I didn't watch it as a writer.
That are just.
If I went by the story alone, it'd be.
But that's why I think the ratings are what they are.
Yeah.
Everybody was trying to get the complete package, so they judged it harshly. We were looking at it for something else, and I think that's why we enjoyed it. I just let the writing go altogether.
Yeah. If you do that. The
plus, I also believe that Marvel and Disney are paying people to post bad reviews. That's just my theory.
I would
that
not
actually,
doubt it. Most of the Marvel
Guy Saeed, the monster, he actually threw that at me, and I was like, you know what? That sounds legit because it was so from day one. Like, they didn't even get
the
Friday.
The movie didn't even come out yet.
Yeah,
they didn't even get
the
screening. They are like, no.
Thursday.
We had reviews 3 months ago.
They were just flooding everywhere on Thursday. I'm like,
damn.
Seriously, not that many people saw it on Thursday. I mean, it was like everywhere. I'm like, when the monster said to me that it was like probably Marvel and Disney paying for people to just post whatever and say, I can see that shit. I can see it. But all it did was make people go find out why.
$500 million.
There you go. So I mean, don't even waste your time trying to trash it.
Just
go see, because
like
people
say,
are gonna go see for themselves.
Good or bad, publicity is publicity.
That's right.
And you still gonna make somebody famous whether it's bad or good.
Awesome.
And the DVD comes out, I think, this summer.
They're not wasting no time.
Yeah, and I can't wait.
DVD comes out tomorrow.
Yeah,
no. Tomorrow.
One week from the movie.
All right, well, I hate to cut this off because we are definitely having a good discussion, but the microphone and the battery on the phone is about to die. So, this was definitely your in-depth movie lingo Batman versus Superman discussion. We're filming now in PPF Past, Present, Future in Davie, Florida, where you can get all kinds of knickknacks, comics, statues,
T-shirts,
standees,
action
Legos,
figures.
Action figures,
Pop comics.
Sign up for the pull list. Yeah.
I am a firm believer of their pull list. I get my comics pulled every week or two. I come and I get my comics.
I'm actually about to.
I'm about to do
start,
mine today.
Start on the Thunderbolt series.
I'm doing Black Panther.
Thunderbolts with an S, because Thunderbolt is
and
a different series.
DC Rebirth.
Yeah, so I'm actually about to get that first issue here today. So
and look them up on Facebook. They also have I believe they have an Instagram now, and Twitter. Past, present, future. They are awesome. They let us film here. They don't make us pay.
And that's why we love them. And hopefully you guys.
And plus, I give them more than enough money.
Yeah. And you guys maybe can come out and film or watch us film. Just leave comments. The more people to follow us, we'll follow you back and we'll interact with you. We thank you for your support. And this is the new season of Movie Lingo. We're back and we're looking forward to Non-Pregnant Iris, Cody, and hopefully more of Ron, and even though some of the other guys you like, Oh Snap Cupcake, hopefully we can get him back on here.
Okay.
That's it.
Okay, we're not saying anybody's name. The baby. Okay, and yeah, so that's it. So thank you for joining us for another Movie Lingo discussion. I'm Eddie Lingo.
And I'm Ron.
I'm Iris.
I'm Cody.
And we'll see you in the next discussion.
Do you bleed?
We'll put that in there.
And blue. God versus man. Day versus night.
The red capes are coming. The red capes are coming.